Are you considering a career in finance but worried that you lack the math skills to succeed? Today, we're tackling one of the biggest questions. How much math do you really need for a job in finance? The truth is, there's no single answer. Finance is a big world with many different roles, and they don't all require you to be a math genius. You might be surprised to hear that many successful people in finance use practical, everyday math skills rather than advanced calculus or complex formulas. Today, I'll explain how much math you need for different finance jobs. But first, please do me a favor, hit that like button, share this video, and subscribe to our channel for more insightful career content. All right, let's get into it. Let's start with investment banking. Investment banking is a fast-paced field focused on helping companies raise capital, facilitating mergers and acquisitions, and providing advisory services. Investment bankers rely on a mix of algebra, statistics, and financial mathematics to perform these tasks. Investment bankers use basic algebra to calculate financial ratios, project revenue and expenses, and perform simple calculations, such as determining interest expenses or break-even points. Statistics play a significant role when analyzing historical data and market trends. By analyzing the mean and standard deviation, bankers understand a company's stability and risk, helping them make informed recommendations. Financial mathematics is at the core of investment banking, especially for discounted cash flow, DCF analysis. DCF calculates an investment's value by discounting future cash flows to their present value, incorporating the time value of money. They calculate return measures, such as net present value, NPV, and internal rate of return, IRR, to determine whether an investment is worth pursuing. In a DCF model, they also use concepts like annuities and perpetuities to value fixed cash flow streams, such as recurring payments. All right, now let's look at the role of a financial analyst. Financial analysts are like detectives in the finance world. They dig into data, track performance, and forecast trends to support business decision-making. As a financial analyst, your math toolkit includes a blend of statistics, probability, and financial mathematics. Statistics is fundamental to a financial analyst's role. Analysts use descriptive statistics, such as mean, median, and standard deviation, to analyze trends and measure variability in financial data. These tools help them understand how sales or costs fluctuate, revealing patterns or potential risks. Probability is also crucial for the financial analyst, particularly in scenario analysis and risk assessment. Analysts often evaluate the likelihood of different outcomes, like projected revenue, under various market conditions. This helps them prepare for various scenarios, making companies better equipped to handle unexpected changes. Then there's financial mathematics, which plays a significant role, especially in DCF analysis. While financial analysts focus on practical data interpretation, another role takes math to the next level, the quantitative analyst, or quant. This role might suit you if you enjoy complex problem solving and advanced mathematical modeling. Quants use high-level math to develop algorithms and models that guide trading and investment strategies. The core math skills for this position include calculus, linear algebra, statistics and probability, and financial mathematics. Calculus is crucial for understanding rates of change, especially in options and derivatives pricing. For instance, the Black-Scholes model uses calculus to calculate the theoretical price of options, factoring in volatility and time. Calculus also helps measure sensitivities, how small changes in market conditions can affect asset prices. Linear algebra is equally essential for this role. In portfolio theory and factor models, quants use matrix algebra to analyze how specific market factors impact asset returns, which helps optimize portfolios. Matrices, vectors, and eigenvectors are vital tools, helping quants understand correlations and diversify portfolios effectively. Statistics and probability are fundamental too, because they're used to model randomness and predict market behavior. Quants rely on probability distributions to forecast price fluctuations and stochastic processes like Brownian motion to model unpredictable stock price movements. Techniques like Monte Carlo simulations are also essential. They allow quants to simulate different market scenarios, stress test strategies, and assess risk. Financial mathematics is crucial for quant, particularly in derivatives pricing. The Black-Scholes formula combines calculus and probability to value options with precision, providing critical insights for trading decisions. All right, now let's discuss accounting, which focuses on ensuring a company's daily financial accuracy and compliance. The math is practical here, balancing ledgers, verifying transactions, and ensuring each number adds up. Basic arithmetic in accounting is essential for everyday tasks. Accountants rely on addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division to balance ledgers, track expenses, and verify transactions. This ensures that records are accurate and everything checks out. Algebra is also vital in accounting, particularly for calculating financial ratios that reveal a company's health. Accountants use ratios like the current ratio and debt-to-equity ratio to assess liquidity and solvency, helping management make informed decisions. Algebra is also used to calculate depreciation schedules and understand department cost allocations. Financial mathematics is essential for accounting, including calculating present and future values, valuing assets, and planning long-term finances. Accountants use the time value of money to evaluate leases, loans, or capital budgets, determining the value of future obligations. All right. While accountants focus on keeping a company's finances accurate and compliant, portfolio management is another role dedicated to managing and growing investments. Portfolio management balances risk to achieve clients' financial goals. They rely on statistics, probability, linear and matrix algebra, and optimization techniques to do this effectively. Statistics is essential for calculating expected returns and measuring portfolio risk. Portfolio managers use metrics like standard deviation to assess volatility, which helps them understand how much a portfolio's value might fluctuate. They also use covariance to analyze the relationships between assets, allowing them to diversify investments strategically and reduce risk across the portfolio. Probability and portfolio management is used to model the likelihood of various outcomes and assess potential returns. Portfolio managers analyze probability distributions to anticipate how asset prices might behave under different market conditions. These insights allow them to prepare for various scenarios, helping them manage risk more effectively. Then there's linear and matrix algebra, which are crucial, particularly in modern portfolio theory. In this framework, managers construct optimal portfolios based on asset correlations. By creating asset returns and covariances, they can calculate the ideal weights for each asset to achieve the desired balance between risk and return. Finally, optimization techniques are used to maximize returns for a given level of risk. A key strategy is the efficient frontier, which helps managers identify the combination of assets that provides the highest possible return for a specific risk level. So, there you have it. The different financial roles and the math skills each relies on. From the practical calculations in accounting to the high-level modeling and quantitative analysis, each role uses math in a unique way. Remember, most of these skills can be learned, and tools like Excel make even complex math more manageable. So, don't let math hold you back from pursuing a finance career. And if you wish to get job ready for a successful career in finance, take this opportunity to subscribe to the 365 Financial Analyst platform. Stay tuned.